Before we start watching part 4 of the Dwayne Neal doc, please look at the first link in the description to help out the Black Lives Matter movement. Remember, we all can change the world and make this world a racist-free one.
Yeah, Dwayne, bro, you gotta be better. You gotta think ahead. You gotta think smarter, smarter, smarter. Dwayne, bro, you gotta pick your teams better. I'm looking at you. You gotta pick your teams better. There's no way a 99 overall player should be... Dude, you're literally the perfect basketball player. That's it. You should be signed to a team with at least one other player. At least one other player that's a 90. You're signed with 34-year-old, 35-year-old Malik Monk and 37-year-old Miles Turner. Like, come on, bro. This is what you want. This is... Oh my God, you are tarnishing your legacy, my guy. Going to LA. I'm not changing my shirt again, bro. If he switches teams, that's it. I'm done. I'm fed up with you, Dwayne. I'm no longer a fan of yours. I'm not following you no matter where you go until you show me that you can win. I don't care about the stats no more. We're looking for W's. We're looking for W's. And one championship, a player of your caliber, is unacceptable. Jordan has 6. LeBron has 3. You got to at least match one of them. You can't be in GOAT conversations. I'm sorry. You can't be in GOAT conversations if you don't win it all.
Dwayne. We've been kind of talking about this, but you've never really quite had a summer like this, given everything that happened, where you are in your career, and as long as you were off. I mean, you had to sit and watch a playoffs and a finals. You haven't played basketball since, I think, April. Mentally, where are you? How did you come through this? Was it a clarifying moment? And did it refocus you? Just where are you in that regard?
You made it sound so bad, like sitting and watching basketball is such a bad thing. I actually enjoyed it. I think you guys seen some of my Instagram posts when I was actually showing you guys me watching the playoffs. I didn't miss one game, by the way, throughout the whole postseason. Not one. I watched every single last one of them. Even when I was on vacation, I watched them. From a competitive side standpoint, obviously you want to be out there, and I wanted to be out there with me and my teammates, but we didn't make it. So you take that as it is. But for me, I'm just trying to refocus myself, refocus my mind and my body, and prepare myself throughout the summer on what I wanted to do, and me individually, how I'm gonna be a better player, a better leader this year, and be as great as I can be to help this franchise do ultimately what it wants to do, and that's to be a better franchise on the floor. We want to be able to compete every single night, and obviously we know what the long-term goal is, but it's all.
How does it feel to shut up the haters and make it far in the playoffs?
It felt nice to shut up the haters, because everyone be talking smack about me everywhere. And making it far in the playoffs really made everyone shut up.
How does it feel to get out of the first round?
It feels great to get out of the first round. Because my teammates actually did something instead of me always carrying the load. I hope you enjoyed this part of the Dwayne Neal doc. Please check out all the links in the description. Stay safe and remember, please sub so I can drop the final part of the Dwayne Neal doc. If we get 1000 views, then I will 100% drop it.